My name is Robin Wiszowaty. This has been one of the most demoralizing years of my life. I've worked at We Charity for nearly 20 years, much of it in Kenya, and have been so proud of everything that we've accomplished. You know, sending 13,000 kids to school every single day and providing tens of thousands of people with clean water. So when the Canadian Broadcasting Corporation started reporting on the political controversy happening in Ottawa involving We Charity and the Trudeau government.
The We Charity controversy.
The We Charity controversy is
Fifth Estate documentary, The Price We Paid. We Charity speak out about what's left in the wake of a political scandal.
I started to see the terrible damage in Kenya, which continues to this day. The reason? Because the CBC is now doing their third feature show in less than a year, attacking We Charity. They're not even trying to tell the whole story. They're disregarding critical facts. They've been calling and challenging our donors for a year, calling one of them 42 times. And perhaps the most troubling to me is that they have deeply disrespected the communities and people with whom we work. So I wanted to share my perspective. And even as I say this, it is still all so hard to believe. We don't have a major megaphone like the CBC uses, but we have the truth and we have our voices. Even the CBC cannot silence us and the people in Kenya with whom we work. Our team members, our community members, and our donors all want to share their experience.
I am a mother, educator, former principal, and someone who believes in the power of girls to change the world. I have never been more upset than my experiences of CBC's dealing with We Charity.
Back in 2020, Carol needed to write a letter to the management at the CBC because they were negatively reporting on her work in Kenya, but refused to give her a voice. They seemed to only want to interview Canadians for a story about rural Africa.
Back in the fall, when CBC was starting their coverage of our work in Kenya, I had to write a letter to the CBC management about them not wanting to hear my voice. As the senior Kenyan representative to the team, as an African woman, I thought my voice mattered when the CBC was reporting about my work in Africa.
Most of us believe the CBC never really wanted to or worked to find any truth. It made it sound as if we were lying to our supporters. They insinuated that we raised money to dig a well and that we had more funders than we needed for the project, which of course is crazy because we don't raise money to just dig a hole in the ground. To provide clean water to thousands of people, you need piping, a tank, power to bring the water up from the ground, someone to monitor it, to take care of it. You need to then bring the water to the schools, to community distribution points, and even to bring water into people's homes. And you need to keep these projects running and sustainable for years. These are basic but important facts. But the problem here, the basis of CBC's claims were the social media postings of past We Charity donors.
One former employee directed us to look at several online posts where different donor organizations appear to take credit for funding the same borehole.
But after airing their segment and after their allegations, it became clear that the CBC was wrong. Donor after donor who they cited on social media contacted the CBC, saying that they were incorrect, that they knew how their money was allocated, and they knew how the water projects worked. The CBC was also incorrect about a donor they cited named James Cohen, who the basis of the CBC's most egregious allegations came from.
James Cohen said the WE organization told him his group paid for the entire borehole in Kipsongle.
After the airing, WE Charity proved that the CBC was wrong about him too. And the CBC issued a clarification in a subsequent article saying, the WE organization told the Fifth Estate there was no donor confusion. In a letter, it pointed to emails where Cohen later understood he was paying for a water kiosk and not the entire borehole. CBC's reporting was fuel for social media and politicians looking to score points against the government. Hearings were held and a supporter of WE's testified, and he raised money to help build schools in his son's name. Unfortunately, WE Charity made an error on a plaque on a school about 15 years ago. We have apologized to him and sought to address the issue. However, CBC jumped on the example to attack We Charity, and most importantly, only told half of his story. Reed initially said that he had raised millions of dollars for the charity, only later clarifying it was closer to 70,000. Reed's lawyers told We Charity in writing, unless we personally paid him $20 million, he would create public infamy for the organization using his media contacts and past employers. Now, CBC has consistently, repeatedly reported on Reed's story, but never once publicly sharing the extortion attempt. I've heard stories about character assassination and fake news and all of that, but I never imagined that the people that I love and have worked with for 20 years would be the target.